Hello, Stanley. We have your car in the hoist. I just want to show you that we have some oil coming from the bottom of the car here. You can see that this is wet, and this is wet here. This rear lower control arm or subframe part of the control arm is wet. The rear floor here that goes all the way to the transmission is, this is all wet. And the reason why it's wet is because the transmission is leaking oil. This is the transmission, and you can see that there's some oil right there, and also there's some oil on the right side of the transmission right there on that screw. So this leak's been going on for quite some time. There's another screw here that's wet. You've had this leak going on for a long time, and this is the reason why. There's oil all over the bottom of the car, from the midsection of the car to the back section of the car. So you have a leak, and you're going to need to replace this transmission pan, because the pan, all the torque, the torque screws for the pan have been overstressed, and the pan itself is not really straight. So I would start with the new transmission pan, and I also would start with resealing this Allen nut screw, because it looks as if though it's getting, the leak is coming from that area. You can see that it's wet right there underneath the Allen screw, and you need to put a new seal on that screw. I will email you an estimate to fix this transmission leak. The next thing, Stanley, we're going to show you is that the oil filter housing is starting to leak oil, and the oil is coming from actually right there in that area of the oil filter cap seal, I believe, is what's causing this to leak, and the oil is just originating from the very top of the oil filter housing and dripping down this way. So we need to remove the cap, oil filter housing cap seal, and put a new one on. Okay, Stanley, the next thing we're going to show you is that there's a lot of oil here under the car, in the front area of the car. This is the engine compartment, and we're looking from the bottom up, and you can see that the power steering pump is actually wet with oil, and you can see I'm flashing the LED on the power steering pump right here, and it's all wet right there, and that's where the oil leak is coming from, is from this power steering pump. We need to reseal the power steering pump and stop this oil leak from getting the whole front of the bottom car, the area getting wet. So I will email you an estimate for that. Okay, Stanley, we have your car on the lift, and I just wanted to show you the brakes on your car. The brakes are touching the wear plate on the car, and when these brake pads right here where the brake pad sensor touch this wear plate, it means that the brake pads are almost finished. You have anywhere from 5 to 10% left on these brake pads. The lights should be coming on soon, so we're recommending that you replace these brake pads soon. The brake light will come on in a short period of time. If it hasn't come on already, it will soon. I just want to let you know that the brake pads are almost finished. Okay, Stanley, the next thing we're going to show you on the car is that the brake fluid in the brake fluid reservoir is very dirty, and it needs to be replaced. Typically, brake fluid is an amber, transparent yellow color, and your brake fluid is a very dark brown, and I recommend that you go ahead and have the brake fluid system flushed. Typically, when brake fluid starts to turn this color, it loses its boiling point, or the boiling point drops dramatically. So if you were up in the mountains and using your brake pedal a lot, the boiling point of your brake fluid would be substantially lower than normal, and you would have brake pedal fade. So you need to have the brake fluid system flushed. This is something the manufacturer recommends you have done every 2 years in order to preserve the braking effort of your brakes, and I'll email you an estimate to do this. The next thing, moving on from your brake fluid, is your overload protection relay. This overload protection relay is the original relay for the car. These overload protection relays should be updated to the new units, because they're basically surge protectors for the electrical system on your car. If your alternator were to go full voltage, it would actually blow this relay fuse off, and the protection that this relay would offer you would practically be nothing. And if the alternator were to go full voltage, it would damage your entire electrical system. So you should update your overload protection relay. It has a double fuse in it, and these relays are improved over this old relay. And this is something that has not been done on your car, and I recommend that you do it. The next thing I'm going to show you is that the engine antifreeze is the wrong color. It's actually a green tinted antifreeze, and you're supposed to have a transparent yellow antifreeze and use Mercedes antifreeze. So this antifreeze is the wrong style antifreeze, and we recommend that you put the Mercedes transparent yellow antifreeze in your engine cooling system. The next thing we recommend is that the windshield washer cap for your windshield washer tank be replaced. It's broken. It looks like somebody put tape on it. So I recommend that you replace the windshield washer reservoir tank cap. The next thing I want to show you is that the headlamp wiper blade inserts are worn out and they need to be replaced. You can see that there's no wiper blade insert here, so you should change the whole wiper headlamp wiper blades. If you were to have your headlights on and use your windshield washer squirters, that's when these motors activate and make the wipers work. So you need to do the left side and the right side, otherwise you could scratch the lenses on your headlights. The
next thing, Stanley, is we're going to show you that the tires are starting to crack, and it's really the rear tires that are all cracking. And you need to replace these rear tires because the date stamp on the battery indicates that these tires are really old. You can see over here that the date stamp is 21/01, which indicates these tires were manufactured on the 21st week of 2001. So you need to replace your rear tires as soon as possible before you get a flat at any time. They can go flat driving the car, or they could go flat when the car is just sitting, but either way, these tires are unsafe and they should be replaced right away. The left rear tire is the same as this right rear tire, so be sure that you've replaced both rear tires as soon as possible. The next thing I want to show you is that the right side tie rod boot is broken and that the right tie rod assembly should be replaced because it's worn out. So I would change the right side tie rod assembly because the boots on the tie rod assembly are worn out and should be changed whenever they're like this. Otherwise, you'll start to hear a steering knock when you turn the wheel left to right. Stanley, we have your car in the hoist, and I'm going to show you the front suspension ball joints. This right front lower control arm ball joint has a broken boot, and you can see with the red LED that the boot is broken right there. And I recommend that you change the right front lower control arm ball joint. And the left front control arm ball joint boot is also broken. So when we go over here to the left side on the front suspension, you can see that the boot on this one is broken as well, and we need to replace it. So right there is where the boot's broken. Eventually the front suspension will start to squeak when all the grease inside the ball joints come out, and you'll need to, at that time, replace the front lower control arm ball joints. I recommend you do it now. It looks like it needs to be done. The next thing I want to show you is that the front suspension on the left front suspension track rod, you can see that the track rod boot joint is starting to crack and we need to replace it. The boot on this is broken, and eventually the front suspension will start to knock and creak when you go over bumps. So we recommend that you change both the left side and the right side track rod because the track rod boot is broken as well on this side too. I don't know if you can see it, but with the LED, I'm trying to point out that the boot is broken on this and all the grease is coming out of it. And when I drove the car around the block, I could hear the front suspension knocking for this reason. So this is something that's going to need your attention if you don't want the front suspension to knock and creak when you go over bumps or dips. Stanley, your hood insulation is deteriorating and I recommend that we replace it. The hood insulation protects the paint on the hood from oxidizing rapidly from the heat transfer of the engine onto the hood panel. So as you can see, the hood insulation pad is falling apart, and I will email you an estimate to fix this.